In this video, we will focus on how to calculate the amount of customers or the amount of receipts that we have. Assuming that every receipt equals a customer, we want to know now how many customers bought something. So we know that the average sales order is $14 and in total of $384 in sales. There are ways to do it, and one of the ways is, for example, to divide this. However, that is, of course, not what we want. What we want to do is we want to find it here. So we have here the receipts, and you can see the receipts here are on a different order. And you might say, well, we just calculate this minus that, and that's it. Well, that's possible. But what if the receipts are, instead of numbers, they have a letter? Let's say they have a letter A at the front, and this one as well. Then that very moment, it will be very hard to calculate. So that is not an option. Luckily, Excel have many functions here where you can use. And one of the functions you can use here is the row function. What does the row function do? Very simple. It calculates, or it indicates which row number it is. So what we want to do here is row. Then we can see here the reference. Let's type in enter. We can see right now we are on row number 5. Of course, we don't want that. What we really want is we want to know, we want to start here at row number 3 and end at row number 29. And of course, you can also calculate like this. You can see how many rows are here. Total of 27, as you see here below. But we need the value being reflected here. So let's go here. You can see here the row. And let's put in here the reference number. Let's open the formula builder and then we say, all right, where's the row? Which row cell do you want? We want this cell. All right. So once we click here and done, we see now we have row 29. So we're almost done here. What we have to do is we have to this row, and then we have to deduct that from row, and that is row number 3. You enter, then you can see here a total of 26, which is incorrect because it should be 22 over 27 in one thing. So what you can do is you can select the row here because it will take the row number 3. So what it does is it 29 minus 3 equals 26. So what we have to do here is plus 1. And then instantly it shows you the amount of customers. So there's 27 customers, and that should be correct because if you have the total sale here, divide by 27, the average should be $14.22. And this is exactly as it shows. And that is how you can use the row function, a very useful tool to quickly calculate the amount of rows, especially useful the moment you have not this amount of rows, but probably a few thousand rows. So if you like to know more about functions on Excel, just check out the link below, and in there you find a nice Excel course that goes deeper in different kind of topics.